Going back to Alfheim?
We still have unfinished business there. There's still that secret elven library in Alfheim.
Sounds good.
I've expanded my inventory since we last spoke.
Now that I've spent time in Asgard, it's strange to imagine Magni and Modi there. Sif raised them both, right? She seems like a good mom. Maybe a little overprotective.
A good mother? Not the Sif I knew. In a culture as debaucherous as the Aesir, being a paragon of womanhood meant being a fierce fighter and a fiercer drinker. She and Thor seldom knew a moment's sobriety, whether brutally dealing with their enemies or, just as brutally, raising those boys.
What do you mean?
Oh, little brother. I know you didn't have an easy childhood, but you can't fathom how much work you can get. Imagine learning discipline by having crashed into you time and again. That was Thor's approach, the same one Odin used on him. A poisonous notion of manhood passed down through generations. A grim inheritance. Leaving all of them the poorer.
Well, Sif doesn't drink anymore. Neither of them do.
I'm quietly flabbergasted to hear it.
I get the sense it's more recent for him. But I know he loves his daughter.
I expect that's the explanation.
Wait. Let us look this way.
Did the lighthouse put this lock here? How would they care what happens in the Baron?
When we were in Vanaheim, Big Bear and Bela spoke of this place. They said it was forbidden. Went on about uncovering some secret history.
Secret history? Sounds like your kind of adventure.
Aye, that's what I said.
Another storm awaits.
Yeah, but at least now we know how to end it.
Mickey!
So, once we free both Hofgoofers and end all the storms, then what?
Healing this land will take more than a pair of singing Hofgoofer. The scars of conflict are woven into the very fabric of the realm. I have to believe, in the long run, we're doing right by Alfheim. But, well, what's your father always saying in this situation?
Keep your expectations low, and you'll never be disappointed.
Wise words.
Well, best we start looking for a way underground.
We gotta find the right cave.
There's the other Hofgoofer, under all that hive! See a way in.
I wasn't sure before, but I'm glad we're doing this. The sandstorm just feels wrong for Alphon.
Aye. Hearing the song of the sands again is a rare privilege. Even if it's only a solo act.
Not once we free this other half, Koopa. It'll be a duet. What is this place? It doesn't look like a Dark Elf cave.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
More hive matter as well.
I'd say we're on the right track, then.
Ew. Guess some of this hive stuff doesn't like sound. Alphon, this hive stuff was all over the realm. It looked unnatural. It was choking the life out of everything. Even the light itself.
It looked that way because you're not from this realm, lad. To the Dark Elves, a hive is more natural than that faultless, lily-white column in the center of the realm. Look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the Lightwell, or even our trapped Hafkifer, for that matter.
You have a point.
I'd like to believe I always do.
This hive looks big. Too thick to cut even. There's more Twilight Stone on the ground. Maybe we can use it. Not sure why that works, but I'm glad it does.
Fetch on the left! Bastards about to explode!
These things smell awful.
Go!
White elves? White elves doing down here? Isn't this dark elf territory?
Territory changes hands often in Alfheim. Or so it appears.
Bigvir did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the light elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Oops.
I suspect the corps below would disagree.
Isn't that the hive that doesn't like sound?
Good eye. Let's continue, shall we?
behind you! Look out!
Hofgoofers free. Are they gonna be able to make more?
Almost certainly. A bittersweet spectacle, considering the cost.
Cost?
Aye. The adult's light fades as they pass it on to their offspring.
Hold on. Are you saying they have to die to have kids?
They don't have to, but the more light they give, the higher the chance of their offspring's survival.
Damn. That's... wow.
It is what parents do.
Really? All parents are supposed to die for their children?
It is what I would do.
Thank you.
Well, here it is. Guess it's time to free it.
You don't seem particularly happy about it, lad.
We're freeing them only for them to die. It doesn't seem fair.
Life seldom is. But their sacrifice will allow their children to thrive. So they will die contented.
I hadn't thought about it like that. If I were one of the children, I wouldn't want them to.
I know, son. But it is the only choice they can make.
Back to the surface, then.
A what?
It's, for relaxation. You burn leaves and breathe the smoke.
Oh, can I use it?
No! The fate of these creatures, it reminds me of a story.
Yeah?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such a power. So the blacksmith used the flame
of... Father, please. It's okay.
What is okay?
You don't have to... Look, I know I get sad about this kind of stuff, but... It doesn't mean I won't be okay, you know?
Yes.
So, what happened with the blacksmith?
His daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died, trying to protect her from those who would open it.
You're not gonna have to do that for me.
I know. But I would.
It appears we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim.
Yet again.
Come on, let's go cut it free.
Whatever my future holds, know this, Atreus. I will always do. What is best for your future? Even these two understand that there is little choice for a parent.
So, are they?
This one's all yours, brother.
You know what? Never mind.
Wow. The Song of the Sands. Well, didn't know I could get misty. It's beautiful.
Thanks, Father, for doing all this. I know it doesn't solve everything, but it feels like we helped.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens?